It's time to find the fees.
So we hear about it a lot. I mean, you know, bonds are they're a safety instrument, and I'll get to that more with Larry here later. I mean, are they thought of as safe, but you know, there's some risks that can be there with bonds. But you know, I think what we've really enjoyed with this segment on finding the fees is talking about, it's important to know where the fees are in investment tools out there. So Danny, go to you first. Are there commissions on bonds? I mean, what are those called?
So those are called markups when it comes to bonds. And so one of the biggest knocks on the investment industry is transparency and trying to understand what's being charged with whatever particular instrument, whether it's a pure stock, whether it's a bond with mutual fund, exchange traded funds, what have you. And so in the case of bonds, a lot of times dealers will bundle their commissions inside the bond, and they call that a markup. And this is akin to the difference between a wholesale price for an item and a retail price. A lot of times, consumers don't even realize that they're paying these commissions, and they're very hard to understand on what's being charged. So there's a lot of cynicism, if you will, that goes along with bonds once the consumer figures out, hey, not everything is being disclosed quite as obvious as maybe it should be.
Yeah, from what I've seen, it's possible for them not even to know what they're being charged until after the sale's already been completed and it's too late to do anything about it.
That's right.
That's silly. Jonathan, I'm going to go to you in Kansas City. Jonathan McCoy, don't people you work with want to know what they're going to be charged before they get charged? I mean, how do you walk people through that?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's just like we use the analogy going to the grocery store all the time. If you are buying a gallon of milk, a carton of eggs, you don't get the bill 10 days later, 6 months later, a year later, when you get a prospectus in the mail for your groceries to tell you exactly how much they cost. And that's when you're expected to pay. No, you're expected to pay when you walk out the door with your products. So when folks come to us, the majority of individuals we talk to already have a financial advisor or already have some sort of investment portfolio in a former company 401k, so on and so forth. And before we walk into, you know, the tax management conversations, so on and so forth, it's important to run through a portfolio analysis, and the analysis of what you own already allows us to make an AB comparison between what are the costs and expenses involved in the funds and the portfolio that you own on top of the advisory fees that you're likely being charged. And how do those compare to a firm like Market Advisor Group? And on your note on bonds, it's also important to note that if you're investing even in bond mutual funds, some of those mutual funds can be as expensive as there are in the world, especially if you're investing in international bond mutual funds, for example, because it's very expensive for those mutual funds to enact trades on those international exchanges. So those expense ratios can escalate quickly.
Yeah. And even on those international exchanges, you have, you know, foreign exchange, you know, to deal with as far as the currency going back and forth. You know, I've been in their appointments where I know you do a good job of walking people through. Now, it's important to know what you're paying for it, but it's also important to know what you're getting for what you're paying, right?
Yeah, that's exactly right. And when we sit down with our CPAs, with our estate planning attorney, with our Medicare advisor, constantly, of course, what we're trying to do is build the internal value, but also looking at for what it's likely costing you to work with your existing advisor, might you be able to pay the same or less and receive a much more well-rounded multiple angles of advice in your retirement plan? And why are you not getting that for what you're already paying? That's a big question.
A great point there. Larry, you know, like I said, at the beginning of the segment, bonds are typically thought of as safe, but if interest rates rise, that can be a risk in the bond portfolio, right?
Yes. And I like to try to explain it this way and have the client just try to picture this. If you buy a bond, the payout to you while you hold that bond is a numeric number, okay? It's a dollar number, not a yield or percentage, but a dollar. That is then converted based on the price of the bond into a percentage. And so if you're looking at a teeter-totter and the base is that numeric number or that dollar amount, as the yields go up, the bond price has to go down. Okay. And so if the yields go down, then the bond price goes up. And the way that affects you is if you decide to get out of that bond before maturity, let's say you don't want to stay in there for 30 years. Then if you go to get out and yields have risen, that means you're going to have to take a discounted price. You're not going to get all your money back on that bond.
Yeah. So what I heard there is there's lots going on there and you have to be aware of it. There's not just a simple safety vehicle. There's a lot of other factors involved, risks, rising rates, the market, markups, all these things you need to be concerned about with. And if you need help with that, feel free to reach out to our office at 833-888-HOUR or 833-888-4687 or email us ask@retirehour.com. Maybe you have a question on what you want to know as far as how the fees are structured for investment tools. Go ahead and shoot us an email there at ask@retirehour.com or go to our website, retirehour.com, and submit your question as well.